Hey Eurovision fans, it's Tom coming to you from Shanghai, back for another Eurovision reaction video. Tonight I'm going to be reacting to Sugar by Natalia Gordienko. She's representing Moldova in Eurovision 2021, and I'm going to listen, react, and see how this could do in semi-final number 2. So, let's kiki. As always, you can use the progress bar if you want to skip to a particular part of the reaction video. I don't know why I've chosen Moldova. I was actually just about to do Slovenia, and then I just had this random change of heart. I'm going through the songs in quite like an arbitrary way. Tending to go like good song, bad song, good bad song, which is why I was going to do Slovenia because I'm expecting it to be pretty bad. But then I was like, ooh, I've heard that Sugar is a bit of a bop and it's a bit fun. I had a trademark change of heart. Okay, as always though, let's talk about Moldova and Eurovision. Moldova are, I love them in Eurovision. They're really completely uninhibited and brave. It seems like nothing's off limits for them. They're a bit of a wild card. Like, they can be absolutely amazing, like when they came third in 2017, or they can absolutely suck. 2017, 2018, they were two top 10 finishes, which other than Mama Beats the Drum, which was their very first entry in 2005, was their kind of best result. Do you know what? They do pretty well, though. If you go, like, 10th in 2007, 11th in 2012 and 2013. Like, they've had some really iconic moments, like 2012, Lautar. I always think of them as like really vivacious and colorful. The staging is quite melodramatic and interesting. So I really love them in the competition. I would absolutely and definitely miss them if they weren't in it. I'd never want them to win or anything because I think them hosting would be maybe a little bit of a disaster, but I absolutely adore what they bring. But yeah, definitely Doritos 2018. That's one of my staging highlights. I think that is probably an example of one of the best elevations of staging from a pretty okay, mediocre song, just elevating it to something really, really, really special. That top 10 finish, they literally pulled that out of nowhere because that song probably wouldn't have qualified. And not only did they qualify, but they got a top 10 out of it almost entirely from the imagination and creativity that went into that stage, and that was really spectacular that year. Sunstroke Project were amazing in 2017. That's one of the very few songs that I've actually heard in China. And I Love 2015, I Want Your Love. It didn't qualify, but here it was him and the Police going all over the place, and that's a real classic NSYNC bop. So look, they can have some really great songs. 2019, they had Anna Obadescu. That song was really, 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 really messy in a hilarious way. Last year, they had Natalia Gordienko. Her song was Prison. Honestly, the song was pretty forgettable. I think it came last in the community. She got internally selected again. That doesn't really bother me. I find the Moldovan national final, like, oozes corruption. So I kind of appreciate them thus doing the favor of not having to go through that rigmarole and just, like, picking her. So the song is written by Dimitrios Kontopoulos and Philip Kokorov. They've composed it. The songwriting's by Sharon Vaughan, so I don't know if she's just done the lyrics. Sharon Vaughan's obviously, she's done Sergei's song in 2019, and she also did both of Vuku's songs. There's some big names behind this. So I'm looking forward to it. I think I've seen a couple of things. Sorry, there's so much pollution in Shanghai today. I don't know, that was such a rambling intro. This can be such a nightmare to edit. I'm actually pretty excited. Oh, let me go transparent so I'm not shouting at you. I love a bop, and I love a big, cheesy, Eurovision, trashy bop, and that's what I want. Okay, so this is Natalia Gordienko, Sugar, One in a Massacre Bang. Ooh, exciting. Come on, something ridiculous. Yes, awesome. This is gonna be so tacky. Oh, I love it. Those visuals are so sharp. It's gonna be dated, but it's gonna be fun. That feet out of the box is awesome. Ooh. God, this is a little bit classier and more expensive than I was expecting. Oh. It's so Russian. Oh, it's so Russian. In a great way. Like, a ridiculous... I hope she says something in the chorus. Say sugar. I don't know why, but I really feel like this song suits her. I don't feel like this is strained for her persona. Oh, damn. Oh, this has got some great beef in this. You know, I don't like it when people don't sing in the chorus, but I think she's pulling it off because we got the dancing. Nice. The close-up of that dude's face is real weird. Yeah, the production is really like... I take back what I said about it being expensive. But I love it. It's great, like. Oh, she's got some honey going on. And she's got some Michael Jackson vibes as well. I love the vivacious colors. Really bright. Oh! Oh god! She's dancing with cones. That is so iconic. Oh, it's so iconic. Please do that at Eurovision. Oh no. Oh, this is really great. I actually wish it was like even more ridiculous. This bit feels a little bit more subdued. I wish it was like even more like lollipops on her head and stuff like that. I have no idea what the lyrics are. I haven't heard this word she said. What? Oh my god. Oh, that is so good. Oh my god, this is so good. This is such a visual feast. It's really distracting me from the song. Wow, okay, that was so epic. I really I love that. I can't remember any of the song. No, I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say I can't remember the song. The visuals were so epic. They were like really eccentric and wild and crazy and uninhibited and just totally letting loose. I love the legs popping out of the box, these pink legs pointing out. It reminds me of this artist. I gotta see if I can get the pictures and I'll pull it up if I remember who it is. But there's this artist, a friend of mine from Estonia used to love, and it always used to have these photos of these women splattered on the ground with all this kind of like fabulous stuff around them. Yeah, I really like that. The song really, it felt a little bit secondary. It was definitely holding its own. It felt umphy and boomphy and it was like thumpy, and it was keeping me going and it was giving me life. I have absolutely no idea what she's saying. I think they picked out one lyric where she's like, I'm addicted to you, which is a pretty obvious lyric for a song called Sugar, where presumably she's comparing the dude to sugar. So I don't think I'm gonna get like much lyrical depth here. It is fun though when you have an upbeat boppy song like this and has some fun stuff that you can say while it's happening. But yeah, the visuals for me were really fantastic. The subdued bit where she was in the kind of like purple, like dark blue purpley dress, I didn't enjoy that as much. I wish they'd kind of gone like 100% wild for the whole thing. I didn't feel like I needed a breather. I would have loved just being like punched around with loads of candy for the whole thing. The bit where she pulls off his jaw and eats it and it's this rainbow cake inside was fantastic. It did also kind of had this like, so like Eastern European style, like some of the camera cuts and the angles are like slightly unusual stuff that you wouldn't expect from kind of like an Anglophone artist. So I quite like that it's got that cultural style in terms of how the video is being filmed and the cinematography. But yeah, I want to go for a second listen. I'm going to focus maybe a little bit more on the song, but like I absolutely love shit like this. I really, really do. This is like one of my favorite things in Eurovision. And I know there's going to be so many people who are going to be like pissed off about this, saying it's real trashy, but I like this trash. I don't want us to turn Eurovision to this thing that's like so ashamed of ourselves and be afraid of like, oh, what will the mainstream think? It's like, well, feck them. This is our show. If they want to come and enjoy it, that's fine. But I don't want to be afraid of what they think about our show. So I don't know. I want to go and listen again to make sure I'm not over exaggerating. But I really, really enjoyed that. Okay, let's go in for a second listen. This is Natalia, one and only Sicker Bang. Oh, the legs. Okay, I'm listening to lyrics, I promise. This song is more than enough. It's not going to reinvent the world or the wheel. It's so dramatic and extra. That's what this whole thing is. It is extra with extra sauce all over it and extra sprinkles. I got a bop on. How can you not have a bop on with this? Attitude, so much attitude, I love it. Sugar, sugar. I wish she said sugar, sugar in the dance bit. Maybe she's gonna ad-lib in the real performance. Those cones are so cheap and amazing. It's like Soviet spy pop. I love it. Amazing. Freaking amazing. I love that so much. Joe, I think that's gonna probably end up being my top 10. I really, really, really like that. I'm so excited for what they're gonna do on the stage. It's got so much potential. And They've got so many fantastic ideas, and one of the things I'm really glad I said in my intro was about Moldova being so uninhibited and brave and colorful and not afraid to send something a little bit like risky or different. And that is exactly sums up Moldova for me so well. Colorful, lively, really fun. I think they really do this fun bit really well. You know, even Aliona Moon, she was like kind of more serious. I still thought that was good, but like when you think of their really great moments, it's Mama Beats the Drum, it's Dorado's Sunstroke Project, it's this like fun, let's party vibe with loads of like great colors and bold graphics and just smacking you across the face, and but also kind of keeping this like Eastern European feel, like slightly dated but in a really endearing and charming way that like it's just, I really, really, really love it. I just don't think you will hear something like this outside of Eurovision. I just think it's a really Eurovision niche song, and I super stan it just from that alone. Yeah, look, the song itself is, it's the type of song that just wouldn't do well in the mainstream because it's got a lot of those kind of like tacky production elements that Kirkhoff is kind of like synonymous with. You know, the Dream Team. I'm sorry, I just don't think the Dream Team. I think they're good. Like I like a lot of the songs that they produce, and I think there's like a good quality to them, but you know, they do sound like they're like 15 years old. But loads of people love music that's 15, 20, 40 years old, but they're not exactly like modern in their compositions. I think she looks great. She looks really natural in this scene. It feels like super authentic to her. It doesn't feel like she's being pushed or stretched. I think she'll pull it off. Personally, I'm not mad on the fact that there's nothing said in the chorus. You know, that's a little bit of my pet peeve. We had it with Roxanne Cherry Red, and we had it with one other person. We had it at Mitana with Elvana in Fick last year. I really don't like that. It just feels like, why not even just say sugar or something like that, or hopefully she can ad-lib that or something. But it just feels like, I suppose if you've got a visual performance, it is a little bit more catered towards Eurovision because then you can just dance through it. But I also want to listen to the song, and I want to listen to her saying sugar. So a little bit, that's one kind of like mini negative. Let's go and have a look at this semi-final. So they're in the second semi-final. They are, I hope they're not in the first half because I have a feeling this is the type of song that might open, and I do not want them to open. Moldova, they don't have Romania in their semi-final this year. I want her to qualify. I think this is a really fantastic form I've seen so far. Obviously we have to see the final performance, but I'm pretty confident that this is going to make it through at this point in time. I would put it in that kind of 6th to 8th region in terms of qualifications. Oh my God, the running order is out. Oh wow, Moldova are 7th. Oh no way. Fuck, okay, sorry, I gotta put this up. Okay, the running order literally just came out. Let me get a screenshot. Okay, so no need to think. They are 7th in the running order. They're sandwiched between Poland and Iceland. Yeah, I think this is gonna be pretty good for them. Sorry, I'm just processing this. I was not expecting the running order to be out. Ooh, damn, I'm really sad about San Marino being pulled first. That's a little bit sad. Okay, so this is 7th in the first half of the semifinal. I think that's a pretty good spot. There's gonna be enough people watching that they're gonna have a lot of viewers. It's gonna come after Poland, which I haven't heard yet, but I'm imagining is pretty mediocre. And so it's gonna stand out because of that. So I definitely wish her luck. Let's have a look in the odds. The odds are gonna freaking be all over the place now because that just came out. She's 15th in the odds, which is really, really good for, sorry, I'm just totally zoned out because I wasn't expecting that. Of the songs in semi-final 2, 6 are above her. So she's 7th in the odds from the semi 2 songs so far. That's a good place to be. And let's have a look at where she is in the community. Ooh, I'm going to put her in my, where am I going to put her? It's a secret. Oh, she's 21st. Okay, she's a little bit lower than I was expecting. That's a little bit sad. I do find that there's quite a lot of people who get a little bit irritated by these kind of upbeat boppy songs. I think Kirkhoff has a lot of people that don't like him as well, but I can get why people wouldn't like this. It is like very in your face, tacky, over the top. Me personally, I just love that kind of energy, so it really, really works for me. Anyway, that's what I think about Sugar by Natalia Gordienko. Please let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already, and thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in another Eurovision Action video very soon. Goodbye.